warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hey everyone, my name is Muhammad Ram Yusuf, esteemed captain of IWF UE for International Technofest UEFI Competition Turkey 2022.
I am Laksamana Aribo, I'm from Mechanic Division.
I am Rahman Muhammad Zuhda and I'm from Mechanic Division.
Farah Abisa Tria, I'm from Mechanic Division.
My name is Muhammad Rizky Pernano and I'm from Electrical and Programming Division.
My name is Pramudita Bintang and I'm from Electrical and Programming Division.
My name is Angkat Umar Syahran and I am from Electrical and Programming Division.
I'm Ananda Putra Iskandar as Manager of the team.
So, we will explain and show you about our vehicle for this competition.
Information regarding the dimensions, weight, and the balance of the UAV can be seen in Table A. The total weight and dimension table information is displayed, while in Table B, contest information about X distance, Y distance, and Z distance.
Before going to the manufacturing stage, firstly, the mechanical division made the detailed design of the fuselage, tail and wing airfoil of the UAV using 3D CAD software. Designs that have been made in the software are printed on the plywood with 5mm thickness using laser cutting method. The shape of the fuselage and tail that have been printed then assembled using adhesive bonding method, where we use ethyl cyanoacrylate glue to form a complete fuselage and tail. The form of the fuselage made with holes intentionally so that the mass of the UAV is light. After being put together, the frame is laminated with monocoat to make it more aerodynamic and good looking so that the UAV has a good performance when flying. After that, the manufacture of the wings that made of a hard foam was first carried out using 2D CNC foam to form the basic shape of the wing. Then the airfoil mold is used to form the airfoil with hot wiring method. After that, the wings are smoothened using sandpaper number 100, 500, and 1000 respectively to get the maximum result. To make it strong, the wings are laminated with fiberglass and resin mixture as the adhesive. Plus, we use rod strip for better strength of the wing. Once the wing finished, we add the landing pad so when doing a landing, the damage to the UAV will be less. Once the wing, the fuselage and the tail are finished, they join together using nut and bolt by using other methods such as 3D printed component as a media.
This competition, we are using S7075 airfoil for a vehicle's main wing. We are using SFLR5 to design and analyze its characteristics. This is the result of the airfoil analysis we have done between minus 20 to 20 degrees angle of attack with 0.5 degrees increments. We also ran this analysis between 50,000 to 500,000 Reynolds numbers with 10,000 increments to get more diverse results. This is the wing design that we are using in this competition. This is the graph of coefficient of lift, drag, and moment for our wing design between minus 20 to 20 degrees angle of attack with 0.5 degrees increments on a constant 20 meters per second airspeed. We can see that the coefficient of moment of this wing always has negative value. This means that the wing has the tendency to pitch up. We can counter this by using well-designed tail to neutralize it.
Our plane used net to hold the ball under the wing. We glue gun this net on one side as a fixed point and on the other side we attach it to the servo. When the servo moves upward, the net will be tight, and if the servo is moved in the opposite direction, the net will be released and the ball will fall.
To connect all the electrical components, first we should flip the vehicle upside down. After that, we could open the bottom doors and we could see this is an electrical component. The first, we could see this is a switch already soldered to the fuse. so we don't have to connect it again. After that, the core module, we could connect it with the ESC. And we have parallelized it from the ESC to, and we could connect it to the BEC or a battery elimiter circuit. The upper section, we could see this is a cable from the motors, and this is cable from the ESC. We could connect it. We could see this is a circuit breaker, and this is a connector to the battery. And then we could connect all the necessary connection to the flight controller. Like this is for from the power module to power the flight controller, and then this is a telemetry. We could connect it to the telem one. So that this is a connector from the GPS. We could connect it to the I2C. We could connect the aileron, elevator, the throttle from the ESC, and the rudder to the flight controller. After that, we could see this is a RC7 and RC8. This is for the dropping servo, and this is RC in. We could connect it to the receiver. We could connect the power from the BEC to the companion computer. After that, we could connect the cable. We could connect the camera. This is the USB to connect it to the camera computer. Okay. That we could place it the upper door, and then we are ready to go. We use circuit breaker that has 50 maximum current to stop the current if overcurrent happens. And WG12 cables to deliver the amount of current safely. After that, we use we also add a switch to stop the battery giving power to the vehicle as quick as possible. Even the impact to the battery, if crash happens, we also add a sponge in front of the battery. To fly safely, we should pay attention to the several parts. The first, we should pay attention to the propeller. Is it mounted tightly or not to the motor and facing to the correct direction. The second, we should check that the motor mounted perfectly to the chassis and rotating to the correct direction. Number 3, check the sponge in the front of the battery. Number 4, check all the components. Is it mounted perfectly to the chassis or not? Number 5, check the wing. Is it mounted to the chassis perfectly? Check all the cable connection. It should connected to the correct position and mounted perfectly. After that, change to the manual mode and check all the control surface. Is it aligned or not? After that, change mode to the stabilize or fly-by-wire and check all the direction from the control surface. Is it correct or not? Last, check the transmission from the remote. Is it good or not? And check the transfer system.
The system itself, we will use Python with the OpenSignal MP, where plus detect the target based on its color and its name. Detect the targets and then will be converted into longitude and latitude coordinates, and will be used as a mission waypoint for the flight controller.
For the autonomous system test, the hardware we use is force and force for the controlling orientation of the plane, and we use a microcontroller which picks up which has accelerometer, gyroscope, barometer, and magnetometer, which connects to the GPS to sense the orientation, position, and controlling of the plane. And we have a Raspberry Pi computer here for the second mission to process and detect the drop zone and plan and program the plan to drop in according coordinate. Also, we have a receiver for the remote to enable control of the plane from the ground, and we have telemetry to monitor plane data from the ground. And for the dropping, we have two servos for dropping the target, and we have one camera sensors on the webcam to sense the target.
Mechanical data, force detail, and battery capacity calculation are presented. Then given data from turning radius 28.57 meters by completing mission 1 with 50 seconds well on mission 2 get an accuracy of 16.7% with a total flight weight of 5028 kilograms. This is a list of quantities and costs of materials and equipment used in the design of a fixed-wing UAV.
There is also the addition of carbon fiber strips to strengthen the wing structure. The difference that can be seen is in the design of the wings and the mechanism of the second mission, which is changed. The wing on the conceptual design have a flat taper model or configuration, which means the front of the wing is flat and the back of the wing is tapered.
All the recordings that are here were made this year for the TechnoFest competition, and we are here to correct that the original recordings are our own.